Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for being here this evening. We're grateful that you are able to join us. My name is Dr. Bryant Smith. I am the Director of Bands at Utah Tech University and thrilled that you can be with us for this evening of music from the British Isles. This particular show is focused on music from Great Britain and from the British Isles for a very specific reason. I'll be taking 15 of my students here to London and Manchester in June, and we will spend 11 days studying music in the British Isles, specifically in London and Manchester. And so we wanted to put on a show of some of that music that would connect very, very well with that trip. The first piece that you heard was by Rafe Vaughan Williams, Flourish for Wind Band. This is his 150th birthday, so happy birthday, Rafe. Good to see you. And excited that we can have the chance to play that for him this year. The next piece that we're going to do is called Nimrod. It is from the Enigma Variations, written by Edward Elgar. It is one of the most revered pieces in British literature. In fact, when I was out in London with my wife here recently, we went out to Windsor, and this song was playing on loop constantly in Windsor Castle, where the Queen is now buried. And so this piece is one that is beloved by those people, and we want to share it with you this evening. So, without further ado, Nimrod by Edward Elgar.
can't say thank you enough for that piece. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, I love that piece. It gives me chills when we do it. It's just wonderful. Makes me happy. We're going to do some chills music here that's different in a very different way. Out of curiosity, I can't see any of you from here, and I don't need house lights or anything, but by applause, how many of you know the music from Riverdance? Good. I was introduced to Riverdance when it came out in 1995, and just absolutely fell in love with it. And I have wanted to do Riverdance for many, many years. This year, we have the band, we have the music, and we are blessed to have the dancers to join us. About a year ago, I began discussions with All American Cloggers to put this together for the show tonight. And they were gracious enough to join us. I'm very grateful for Nicole Hadley and Meg Nielsen for helping us put this together. They've been wonderful to work with. And we're very excited too, because yesterday we spent 2 hours shooting a music video with this group and with the dancers. So you can look for that sometime on YouTube. I don't know when, sometime in the coming months, but we're excited about that. So we're gonna play the music from Riverdance. It's about 15 minutes of the music from the show. Sorry if you were hoping for the full show, you have to go somewhere else for that. But I'm excited that we can share this with you tonight. So, did I give you enough time? Yes. Sure, okay, it'll be awesome. Let us do the music from Riverdance, and we hope that you enjoy this with the Utah Tech Symphonic Band featuring All American Cloggers. Here we go.
Shall we? Let's have some fun.
One more big round of applause for All-American Cloggers, please. Come back out, please, All-American Cloggers. And one more round of applause for the Utah Tech Symphonic Band, at peace. a stage that we, whoa.
Hi.
Okay. No, we needed all the stage we could get on that one so we could get everyone up here dancing. Did you enjoy that like I enjoyed that? My goodness. I love that music and I love that show. I'm so grateful we could perform that for you. How many people like Boy That Lived? Also known as Harry Potter. We have to kind of cheat a little bit here because we're doing John Williams' version and he is definitely American. But it's a British movie, so we're gonna do it, a British story. We're gonna do some music from the first Harry Potter movie. This is music from Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. It's the symphonic suite arranged by Robert W. Smith, written, of course, by the great John Williams. John Williams is the man. Absolutely wonderful. So this one features a whole bunch of people in the band, and I'm just looking forward to seeing them play this. But you'll hear different themes from it. You'll hear Quidditch stuff. You'll hear Hogwarts Forever. It's one of my favorite parts there. So lots of fun things. But we're going to spend some time on this. One of the reasons that we wanted to do this is because those 15 students who are going on study abroad through the Utah Tech Study Abroad program are going to go to the Harry Potter experience, and we're going to go see all the set stuff and all the costumes, all that kind of stuff. So kind of a fun opportunity to have some fun with this. So without further ado, let's do some Harry Potter.
had a solo. Who else had a solo? You had a solo. Gosh, nobody had a solo. You had a solo. I don't know.
If you will give us just a moment for a quick scene change. You don't have to leave your seats. We'll be done in just a moment, but we'll be back with a little bit of rock in just a moment. Hello, hello. There we go. Hi, everybody. Okay, we're coming back, and this is a very different setup than what we've had all night. If you're going to do a British show, you can't do a British show without some British rock. And if you're like me, British rock could mean a lot of things, but tonight it's going to mean Pink Floyd. And this is another piece that we shot a music video for, so you can look for that in coming months. But I decided that it would be a lot of fun for me to merge a couple of the worlds that I play in regularly, that being my wonderful job with these awesome students who are just doing fantastic tonight. Can we give them another round of applause? Because they're awesome. Excellent. The other group that that I spend some time with and have been for the last 6 years or so is the group that you see on stage. This is JR and the Mulberries. We are a local rock band here in town, and we've played a whole bunch of different gigs and had a great time doing it, and feel very blessed to be able to bring my friends from JR and the Mulberries together with my friends in the symphonic band at Utah Tech to do a little Pink Floyd for you tonight. So we hope that you enjoy Comfortably Numb for you this evening. Shall we? Oh, I need to say one more thing. Obviously, I'm not waving a stick right now. We have a wonderful guest conductor, one of my students right now. Ethan Burkett is taking the stand this evening. Please give him a round of applause and welcome him. Nod if you can hear me. Is there anyone at home? Come on now. I hear you feeling down. Well, I can ease your pain, get you on your feet again. Relax. I need some information first. Just the basic facts. Can you show me where it hurts?
There is no pain you are receiving. A distant ship smoke on the horizon. You are only coming through in waves. Your lips move, but I can't hear what you say. When I was a child, I had a fever. My hands felt just like two balloons. Now I've got that feeling once again. I can't explain, you would not understand. This is not how I am. I have become comfortably numb. Comfortably numb.
Okay. Just a little pinprick. There'll be no more. But you may feel a little sick. Can you stand up?
Stand up.
I do believe it's working. Good. That'll keep you going for the show. Come on, it's time to go.
There is no pain, you are receding. A distant ship smoke on the horizon. You are only coming through in waves. Your lips move, but I can't hear what you say. When I was a child, I had a fleeting glimpse. out of the corner of my eye. I turned to look, but it was gone. I cannot put my finger on it now. The child is grown and the dream is gone. I have become comfortably numb.
JR and the Mulberries, ladies and gentlemen. With conductor Ethan Burkett. Isn't that the coolest contraption you've ever seen? That magically appeared yesterday. Like, just, they're like, yeah, we went to Lowe's, we spent like $60, and voila, it's awesome. I don't know how they do that, but that's awesome. This would be a great time, by the way, to give a huge round of applause to Amy and her crew who are doing all the tech, all the lights, all the pictures, all the fog, everything cool and moving equipment at the same time. We should give them all a huge round of applause. Bravo. Bravo, you guys. Thank you so much up there in the booth. We really appreciate y'all and all backstage. Thank you.
We just have one more. I'm not forgetting any, am I?
Okay, cool. All right, so we have one more for you. This is a piece that is new to me. My wife and I were in London preparing for the study abroad, and there was a piece that was played. We went to Royal Albert Hall, and we heard about 7 hours of brass bands, and they only played one song over and over and over again. It's a 15-minute long song. It was nutso. So they played this one song, and I just had to do it. We had to do it, and so we thought tonight this would be our closer. Before we do that, I want to thank you all for coming out to our performance tonight. We greatly appreciate you here at Utah Tech. We want our audiences to keep coming back. We want you to keep enjoying all the concerts that we have. And we hope that you will join us for many future shows and support these wonderful students. You're coming to a show that's made up of students, kids from all sorts of majors. Just out of curiosity, just for fun, band members, how many of you are not music majors? Please raise your hand high. That should tell you something about how awesome these kids are. We have many music majors as well, and they play in a whole bunch of different organizations, including this one. We have orchestra that's playing all the time, small chamber ensembles, jazz band, pep band, marching band. Our pep band goes to the basketball tournament next week, and we start that whole chapter in our history. There's lots of arts happening at Utah Tech, and it doesn't matter if you're a music major or not. You come and you enjoy music because you love music. And that's, I'm really proud of these kids for doing so much. Bravo to them. By the way, do we have any Utah Tech faculty in the audience right now? I usually do this earlier, but I'll do it now. Who is there? I see Rhonda Rhodes over there. I can't see anyone else. I know Gary Caldwell, Maestro Gary Caldwell, is behind me here. He's awesome. He's playing in the band still. If I can't see you and you're here, either shout your name out or just know that we love you. Roe Webb is here. Roe Webb. Thank you, Roe. Glad you're here. Welcome. Excellent. Anybody else want to take it out? Okay, we're good. Very good. So we will now conclude this evening's performance with a very fun march. It is called The Padstow Lifeboat, written by Malcolm Arnold. The Padstow Lifeboat is just what you would expect, a lifeboat that goes out of the area of Padstow and goes and rescues people. Malcolm Arnold used to live near there, and he used to listen to the foghorn, or the horn, I guess I should say, at the lighthouse that would go off. So we hope that you enjoy this, and we hope that you can find the foghorn. I don't think you'll be able to miss it. So enjoy this, and thank you again for coming to our show this evening. Padstow Lifeboat. Thank you.
Thank you.